say the applause or wait until the act. I don't want you to be the only audience. I can't. I'm going to tell you a story about a friendship I had with a girl in in the fifth grade, at the start of fifth grade, I became friends with this girl because she was friends with one of my friends, so we kind of connected in that way. And for some reason, we really clicked. I mean, she found my sense of humor funny, I found her sense of humor funny, and you know, over the year I would admire and look out cartoons that she would often make, like cartoons of rockets and bananas. Yeah, puberty was hitting us both pretty hard. Anyway, over the course of the fifth grade, I became an actor in the musical production of the musical Adventures of Fat Stanley Jr. I'll repeat that again because one tone in there sounds vaguely important. The musical Adventures of Fat Stanley Jr. What was in the musical Adventures of Fat Stanley Sr. that we had to go and do the junior edition? When Stanley turned fat, was he like, "God damn it, I'm fat now!" Or what? Did Fat Stanley walk up to a mailbox and like have a really intimate love kissing scene with him? With his really flat lips, so it was really disgusting. But anyway, after I stopped thinking about disgusting things like that, and it was a lot of fun, and so I decided to tell my mom that I was going to do the fetal elective in the sixth grade, because it was so much fun. And the problem with that was, this girl that I had become friends with, she was going to do the robotics elective instead. And we didn't really have any classes together at all. And I didn't talk to her until one day in the sixth grade, it was November or something, October. I was sitting at a table doing lunch and she walked over to me. And she asked me, "Hey, do you want to sit with me and my friends?" And I just said, "No, thank you. I'm fine here, sitting by myself." And then she just chuckled and she hugged me. Like, she actually hugged me. She actually hugged me. That was the first time I had been touched by a girl that wasn't my mom. But then, because of that incident, I started to have feelings for her, and because of that, I couldn't talk to her at all because of these feelings that I wanted to share, and I just couldn't be friends with her again. Literally, that was the last time I ever talked to her. Just that one little conversation leading to a hug because of... The only reason as to why I even chose the fetal elective over the robotics elective was because of this childish impulse I had, this stupid decision-making brain I had. You know, to be an actor one day, because back then, the only thing that made me happy was watching actors on TV, because, you know, they were perfect. And I wanted to be like that. And I wanted my friends to be like that. But, you know, none of my friends were perfect, so I was just alone, myself. I still feel stupid for not even bothering to talk to her. You know, ever since the sixth grade, it's just been, I hate myself, I want to kill myself, I want to jump off a bridge, I want to freaking drink a lot of milk. You know, I would do anything to remember what it was like to be a friend in a heartbeat. And, you know, now that I think about it, we didn't even have that much in common in the first place. For one thing, I liked to do fetal, and she couldn't dream about doing fetal in 1,000 years. She liked to draw, and I liked to draw, except I sucked. You know, and I tried to mimic her rockets and bananas, but the bananas didn't exactly come across as bananas. But most most importantly, she was outgoing, social, kind. I was autistic. And autistic people generally suck. Do you know what's sad? When I was writing this, I freaking pulled my eyes out and cried. But do you know what's even sad? I was crying because I was rubbing a pimple on my eyebrow. Once again, puberty strikes again. So, as an autistic person, I have several disadvantages in my life. For one thing, I have a very hard time accepting change. Like one time, my dad put strawberry jelly in my peanut butter and jelly sandwich without telling me instead of grape jelly, because he didn't think that when I took a bite of it, that it would spit right back in his face. It was almost like a ligature, actually, in my mouth, in his face. Second of all, I am a narcissistic a-hole who can't even spell the word narcissistic. And I have a general disdain for all human life and all of you. Really, every single one of you, really disappoint me. And third of all, spit a little bit there. I am an uncoordinated tool with a ginormous amount of leg fat. Now you might be thinking, oh, he's got bulgy calves, those must be leg muscles, right? No, this is the result of 15 years of a diet which consists of strawberry Dunkin' Donuts. It's all come down here. In fact, it kind of got stuck here. This is a Dunkin' Donut. And you know, it's not just in my legs that I'm completely uncoordinated. You know, I also uncoordinated with my arms. And sometimes my arms have these little freak out attacks. Like they just have this weird impulse. And sometimes I'm walking next to a boy and all of a sudden my arm goes and I hit his arm. And you know, it's usually fine because you know I apologize to him right away and you know we just move on with our lives and I never see him again. But when this happens to a girl, and I'm walking next to her, I don't hit her arm. Instead, my arm tends to stretch out and hit her in the, we're looking up a proper term for the two circular things. I came across the term jelly balls. So from now on, I'm just going to move forward. And the last time, so I've done this at least, this incident has happened at least 3 times. Okay, a dozen. And the last time it happened, I was walking next to a girl, classic setup, and all of a sudden my arm just went. And this was like 6 months ago, and the school was like, oh my god, what's your problem? Are you a pole? And then she started walking away. And I was like, no way, you know, after having become a victim to my autistic arm freak out attack, I yelled to her, no way, I'm not a pole, I'm just autistic. And that made her work.